CEDSAC, is that, I'm just going to use the acronyms from here on out.
No problem.
Thank you, Ms. Bird.
Is my mic on?
Yeah.
First, thank you. So I am with the Local Economic Development Lab, but I've been seconded to the Community Economic Development Strategic Action Committee since June 1st in the capacity of a facilitator and process designer. So I'm going to be pretty quick today, and I'm going to talk to you at a high level about the process that I experienced, what I observed in the last 6 months. So since June 1st, I have watched the 35 different organizations, activist group, residents, EIAs, a very diverse committee of people really learn to work together and grow together. I've seen our committee members be very generous in their contributions to this strategy. People prioritized this work because they felt that it had the opportunity to create systemic change. Many members were very thoughtful in their comments. I witnessed people really listening to each other, to raising concerns articulately and with tact. And when, you know, the energy in a room can really shift when an idea is put forward and others realize that they also want the same thing, and sort of energy is really built around some of the initiatives that are included in the strategy that you're looking at today, including the CART system that Wes was talking about, or CPA policy, as I know our co-chair Colin will be talking about in a couple of minutes. I think we've really done our best to create an inclusive process. So we did allow people to come into the process sort of within the first couple of meetings. We provided written materials in advance that could be picked up at City Hall, Social Policy, at Carnegie Community Center. We did provide translation at our open houses in Cantonese and Mandarin. We tried to connect residents who don't have phones who don't have email by phone. So Alicia has done a lot of really great work at making herself accessible and available in a variety of ways to both residents and as well as the organizations that that we've been meeting with. So we've tried to be very flexible in this process. So what's happened in each of these interactions is that I've really witnessed the relationships between people in this committee change, and there's a palpable appetite to work together and to collaborate that is really exciting to me. And as we worked with Wes, Tom, and Mary Claire, our relationship to the city of Vancouver really changed, and the vulnerability that Wes was talking about earlier, I know mattered a lot to committee members, that there was this two-way dialogue that was happening through this process was really, really exciting. So trust is built through repeated interactions that are characterized by honesty and authenticity. That's what I believe. And in fact, there's another part of building trust, which is following through. So I think my recommendation here today is very clear. So let's adopt the CED strategy. Let's respect the work that went into the process. And let's build the foundation of trust between the city and the community in order to advance this shared work together. And 693 is the number of hours that committee members dedicated to this process in an accelerated timeline. So I think that's really impressive. And the final point I want to make is that the recommendations that are in the CED strategy, the CED strategy co-creation process wasn't the beginning of the new process. This is really built upon, as Wes has mentioned, the work of the local area plan, and really built upon work that's already going on in the community. Wes talked about catching up, right? So many of the ideas that were put forward and are included in the strategy that's in front of you today have been developed by existing groups and networks like CCAP or Our Place or Urban Core. So it's really important that as we move forward, that we recognize that there's this whole concert of community economic development activities really happening in the area. And the CED Strategic Action Committee is one vehicle for change and impact, but it's not the only vehicle. So it's important that we work together and we stay closely connected to many of these different, the poverty advocacy coalition, I'm not sure exactly what they're called, or the sex worker exiting roundtable. There's the now Metro Vancouver Aboriginal Executive Committee. So there's all of these other groups that are meeting just like us, and we need to ensure that we stay connected and respect all the work that's already going on.